Gemini, welcome. We're going to do a general read for you guys today. Looking at your current energy, desire, outcome, what's working for you, what you need to be aware of. Once we've got those cards on the table, we will clarify them to get the better story. And then at the end, we'll pull three more cards around the read just to make sure we have everything on the table for you, Gemini. Fool tried to pop out, so we'll see if that shows up again later. But let's figure out what your current energies are. Queen of Wands. Queen of Wands shows up. Somebody's feeling like the belle at the ball. The desire, though, is Eight of Wands. Somebody's wanting, looks like you're wanting some type of communication to come in or things to start happening. And the Ten of Pentacles is the outcome. Ten of Pentacles being sort of everything material-wise coming into your life. Then we have the Tower. That's what's working for you. So some type of energy that's coming in to dispel misbeliefs. And the Hierophant is what you need to be aware of. Hierophant can be somebody that is there to lead you, but it can also speak to a major commitment such as marriage. So let's start to clarify what this Queen of Wands is doing here. Strength card, Queen of Cups, and the Page of Wands. Now the Queen of Wands is somebody that's very cheerful, very busy, they're out there, but underneath that we see the Strength card, the Queen of Cups, and the Page of Wands. There's almost this feeling of rashness where you need to control, or maybe you're having a hard time controlling your emotions regarding certain types of information that are coming into you, maybe regarding work or just some type of communication in general that seems to really cause the storm surge. The Eight of Wands. What you're looking for to break loose and really start to move forward for you, and we see that the desire is very, very strong, especially with the Chariot showing up. We see that there's this push, that you're just craving this information or just things to break loose and head forward. Could be into a marriage type situation, but just that it's been a while since, you know, there's been good news come in. But we also see that there's this desire for this self-sufficiency and abundance to come in. And the happiness that that'll bring when those things are there. We had the Two of Cups show up, the Hermit. Two of Cups almost fell out, so we're going to take it. So in the outcome, we have the Ten of Pentacles. And underneath that, we have the Two of Cups, the Hermit, and the Nine of Swords. This really feels like this Ten of Pentacles is tied to some type of connection that you have with somebody. That you see this is a path that you can be walking alone currently, but it's going to change. But walking alone for some reason brings stress. So we can see that in this, you want somebody that can walk hand in hand with you and walk this path in order to eliminate this Nine of Swords, this stress. The Tower. With the Tower, this is what's working for you. We have the Queen of Swords, Eight of Swords, Eight of Pentacles. When I look at this tower, and this tower sort of forces a decisive sort of moment, or for you to be very clear, but I almost get the feeling that you're more than capable to eliminate this Nine of Swords and this sort of stuck thinking as you start to work on things yourself. When we have the Eight of Pentacles here, the Nine of Pentacles, the Ten. So as you start to work things yourself, we see that that fear sort of dissipates because now you've put yourself in control. So not that it had to be with somebody else, but we understand that sometimes taking that first step alone can be the hard one. Interesting is that what's working for you is we have the Hierophant here, the Wheel of Fortune, the Two of Swords, and the King of Swords. So we have the King and Queen of Swords on the table. And this to me is, there is a relationship underneath this. And with the Hierophant card, yes, there is a relationship here where you are matched. The Two of Cups speaks of an energetic match as well. We have the Two of Swords, that this wheel starts to move, and we have the Wheel of Fortune. So this wheel starts to move, or it's changing a cycle for you in which you're really maybe not sure which way to go. But as you focus your energies and start to plan things out and be decisive with what's going on, we see that that changes for you. That wheel starts to move quicker. And then we have the King of Pentacles, the Six of Wands, and the Ace of Cups. So as this starts to move, we see that things start to get a little more comfy at home. You notice almost like a step up. You feel like you've stepped up. And then, of course, once that starts to happen, we see this relationship. Excuse me. We see this relationship come in with the Ace of Cups. It's not like I'm going through puberty for the first time. choking on myself right now. Sorry about that. But we see that, you know, all of a sudden things get comfortable as you get decisive. This relationship brings sort of two things to you. One is the stability that you're craving. The other is the harmony that it brings and allows you to move forward with somebody there into the dreams and the realities that you wish. So that's what I have for you today, Gemini. Best of luck this week. Feel free to give this a thumbs up or thumbs down. We'll see you next time. Stay safe.